At David Security come to you once again, sharing security insights for all you travelers, expats, and digital nomads out there wanting to explore the world safely. And today we are happy to share with you our 5-minute travel security report, where we're going to provide every Thursday for Travel Thursday, we're going to provide you with an informative and hopefully entertaining country security brief. So we're going to make sure to provide you with insights about the country. So I'm not out here trying to sell you a travel guide or some tours or anything like that. I want to give you a solid security foundation. So make sure to like this video if you like this content. Also, feel free to subscribe to the channel if you want to receive a regular security and travel updates on this channel. Now, let's get right into it. For this series, we're going to start off with one of our favorite countries because, well, we lived there for almost a decade. But still, Tunisia is a great place to start the series because it offers travelers an opportunity to experience history, culture, and what I like to call Africa a la European, whatever that means. But let's get right into it here with geography. Now, Tunisia is at the northmost point of Africa and is bordered on the west by Algeria and by Libya on the south. So it's not in the best neighborhood, but Tunisians are one of the most friendliest and welcoming people you will ever meet. Trust me. But that changes a little bit once you start driving in Tunisia. So I highly recommend that you don't drive and avoid driving at all costs. That brings us to our safety concerns about Tunisia. Now, road safety poses one of the greatest risks to foreign travelers. Now, according to the Tunisian National Road Safety Observatory, there were more than 6,700 recorded traffic accidents and approximately over 1,421 traffic-related deaths. Road safety is definitely an issue in Tunisia. So on that note, I also want to add that you should not, and I don't advise anyone to take public transportations. That includes the minibuses, the yellow minibuses you're going to see everywhere. And the reason why I suggest that is because, well, these drivers, they have a need for speed that you wouldn't believe. So definitely avoid that. Now, the U.S. State Department has assessed Tunis as being a low threat location for crimes. So we're going to talk about two assessments. You have the crime and you have terrorism. Let's just talk a little bit about crime. So the U.S. State Department has assessed Tunis as being a low threat environment for crime. So it's also, but it's also worth noting that crime involving the use of firearms is pretty rare in Tunisia. Although violent and non-violent crimes like personal robberies, residential break-ins, and things of that nature does occur in Tunis like it does in any other major city. Now, the most reported criminal incidents against foreigners are crimes of opportunity. So if you do not present the opportunity, chances are you will not become a victim of a crime in Tunisia. Now, the targets that are usually sought after in Tunisia as far as from criminals tends to be foreigners who appear to be unfamiliar with their surroundings and look very, shall we say, tourist-like. So definitely try to avoid that. Now let's talk about the terrorism threat in Tunisia. The U.S. State Department has assessed Tunis as being a high threat location for terrorism. So this doesn't mean they should avoid going to Tunisia. It's just important to note that there is a state of emergency put in place in Tunisia after an incident that took place in 2015. So this state of emergency pretty much gets renewed every month. So Tunisia is you can say in a ongoing state of emergency in regards to being an alert for terrorism and terrorist activities. But there have also been some notable terrorist attacks, mainly against Tunisian security forces. So that is something to keep in mind. Moving on here, let's talk about health and safety. Well, we all know that the pandemic is still an ongoing issue, and it is something to consider because Tunisia has been affected, as have most countries throughout the world. But the important thing when visiting Tunisia is to know the requirements before traveling, and at the minimum, be prepared to present a recent 72 hours or less PCR test. wrapping it up here, giving you the security brief in 5 minutes or less. Wrapping it up here, I would like to give my overall rating of Tunisia. So I give Tunisia a 4.7 out of 5 in terms of travel safety. That is unless you, of course, you are one of those adventure-seeking folks that likes to hang out by the border, or maybe you'd like to go out a stroll in the desert by yourself, or climb a restricted mountain. So if you avoid those activities, you're pretty much going to guarantee yourself to have a fantastic time in Tunisia. So just use the same strategies and the same mindset you would in any major city, using situational awareness, and you will greatly reduce your chances of being a victim of crime. So that's your Tunisia travel security brief. Let me know what you think in the comment section. Let me know what your experience was there in Tunisia. And feel free to check out our Tunisia Security Update Facebook page for more updates on Tunisia. And if you want to interact with other travelers and foreigners and expats that love Tunisia. So that's your 5-minute travel security brief for Tunisia. Let me know what you think. At David Security here, reminding you to travel safe, and let's keep it going. Take care.